Well, it's now like 8:10. I'm in South Carolina by about 50 miles, I think. Something like that. Somewhere up here, in about another 30 miles, I turn off 95, get on to 26. I already talked to Shonda. She called me about 2 hours ago. She's having a little bit of a hard time. It's a lot of, you know, it's a lot of stuff going on all at once. You know, she just found herself, you know, maybe going and then not going, and now she's, with the help of my folks, you know, trying to wrangle the kids and drop one off at daycare, the other one off at school, and then get to work at, you know, three different parts of the city, actually across two different counties. So she's kind of got her hands full, but she does have help. I think it's a lot of it's that she does, you know, she and I, I don't either, doesn't do well when we're apart. We have talked about codependence, jokingly, if nothing else. But I don't, I don't think that it's that, because we're not so dependent that we can't function without each other. We can function on our own fine. It's just we so absolutely love to be around each other and want to be around each other that when we're not, it's, you know, it's not so bad when, you know, when you're at work, you know, you get to come home and, you know, see each other. But when it's something like this, you know, we're one of you's out of state, you know, and the time frame is sort of up in the air. It's difficult. It's tough. Well, anyway, I guess I'm gonna wander around, stretch my legs, see if I can wake up a little bit. If that doesn't do it, I'll either pop some Vivarin or yay for, you know, over-the-counter caffeine pills. Or just put the seat back and try and catch a nap or something. I worry about doing that though, because I don't light sleep. When I crash, I crash. And my concern is that, you know, a potential 30-minute nap will turn into like 5 hours. I'll be out on my ass in the car, and that's just not gonna